we can start with, you know, the number 20, then the number 3, the number 7. You can start with 7, you can go on to 20, but like just explaining what the meaning behind those three numbers is would be a good way to go. So who wants to explain any one of those numbers, 20, 3, 7? Kaden?
Okay. 20, then how many times do you have to go up from 1?
So, how many? You go up from 1.
And then 3.
Wait, let's stay on 20 for a second. Okay, so here's to, in case, not sure what Kaden means. Okay, here's figure 1, figure 2, figure 3. Right, figure 4, figure 5, 6, the pattern will just continue and continue and continue. Figure 1 to figure 2, right, this is the part that Katie's talking about, it takes how many steps, Zach?
1.
Yeah, 1 step, right? When you try and puzzle someone else and ask them the same kind of question, except for, like, which figure do you want to go to?
12.
Okay, 12, so we're going to go from figure 1 to figure 12. 1 step, 2 steps, 3 steps. 4 steps. How many steps will we go by the time we get to number 12?
11.
Okay. It was the other class, Jasper Roberts, came up with this way of thinking of it. He said, well, I think of it like days, right? First day, second day, third day. It certainly is a decent way of thinking about it. First figure, second figure, third figure, first day, second figure, third day. So it was the first day, and I'm thinking about the 12th day. Right? How many days until the 12th day?
11
days, right? We don't count today. We just count how many days in between. So there's another way of thinking about it. All right? So then the ultimate question, how many steps does it take to get from here to figure 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 21, JC?
20.
It takes 20 steps, okay? All right, so let's take on number 3. What's the number 3?
The 3 is how many is like added on to each figure.
Okay, so 3 blocks added every figure. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
3 blocks added every figure. Right. So here's that first figure. If we put one there and, oh, that's not going to show up very well. If we put one there, there, and there, what do we have?
Figure 2.
Figure 2. If we put one there, there, and there, what do we have? On doing that, right? Put one on the bottom right, the top right, and the top left. We make the next figure that just requires 3 blocks. We're not really asking what the figure is going to look like, but what it's going to, how many blocks it's going to have. Alright. So this part of it is just counting up what? Number of blocks. Well, this is like a little bit more specific than the number of blocks. Which blocks is it counting up?
Blocks until figure 4.
Figure 21. Number of blocks until?
No, it's added. Until
is that what you meant? So the number of blocks that you would add on in total once you went from figure 1 to figure 21? All right, Zach, are you going to take on the last part there?
Well, I was going to say number 3 is the rate of change.
Oh, good. Yeah, that's to use like some of our previous learning. The rate of change. How much does the number of blocks change? 3. The rate of change is 3. Okay. The idea behind this is like we've dealt with linear functions for quite a bit. We've evaluated them. We've solved some equations. We've worked with some functions. We've graphed some functions. Okay. And now, many times over, we've tried as a class to understand writing linear functions, but it's proved pretty challenging. Okay. One thing that was a challenge was the rate of change, as Zach said, would be sometimes a fraction. Okay, you guys are having some trouble with that. So here, the nice thing about the rate of change is, in all of these, since we go from figure 1 to figure 2 to figure 3, not from figure 1 to figure 7, right? There's not these big gaps there. 1, 2, 3. And all these blocks goes up by a whole number. Okay, 3, 5, 7, whatever the number of blocks goes up. The rate of change is this nice whole number, but it is still a rate of change, a simple rate of change. I think an easily grasped rate of change, but yeah, so all those words to say what Zach said, the rate of change, it's good vocab. Who wants to explain the 7?
The number of blocks in figure 1.
Why is that important?
Because it has 20, you minus the 1, the first figure,
okay.
Then you go up 3, but you have to add it back to get the entire TU.
So, in other words, this part is only part of figure 21, right? What part is it?
Many threes or blocks you add to.
How many blocks you would get after you added so many threes? If you added 20 threes onto it. But again, we said it a minute ago, this is just how many blocks are added on to the first figure. So until we add the first figure on, we kind of ignored it. So we add that figure on, plus, you know, we take that first figure and we add on 20 groups of 3 blocks. So we add on 7 because this is the number of blocks in figure 1. Does it make sense? Everybody cool with that? Right, so like that's like a starting point. Instead, if we were to graph this, it would just be like a steady moving up, nice and steady, just a constant rate of change. Like our y-intercept, there's our slope, there's, well, a specific x value, but don't worry about that right now. All right, so that's why that works. I think that approach makes a lot of sense. All right. I think it probably is the easiest to talk about. There's lots of different approaches we could use. We could start at 3. We could start at figure 3 if we wanted to. And then figure out how many steps from figure 3 to figure 21 is kind of a silly thing to think about. I think from figure 1 on up would make more sense.
Right.
So to take 1 off always. And I think it's a, yeah. Why else call it 1 if it's not a good place to start? But when I start at 3, I might as well shift it over and call it 1. But let's try this. So this gives us how many?
67.
What does this give us?
67.
You tried them both?
Yeah.
Yeah. So this gives us 67. Do you think it's a fluke?
No.
It's a different way to go.
Let's just investigate whether or not it's a fluke. It's not a fluke, but let's look at like fluke, yeah. So if we were to apply it to figure 3, actually let's apply it to figure 4 so the numbers aren't as confusing. So figure 4, how many would be in figure 4 then, just by looking at the pattern? How many would be in the next figure? We got 7 here.
16.
10, 13, 16. So, if this approach works, then it should work for figure 4. It should give us 16. So let's try it. Well, if we're going to figure 4, then we would do 3, right, for the number of steps. 1, 2, 3 times what?
4.
4.
Wait.
Again, this is the number of steps to get to figure 4. It only takes 3.
3.
This 3 is because
that's how many you're going up by.
Yeah, there's our rate of change, how many blocks are added every time, however you want to look at it. That's annoying. And then we'll add 4. So 3 times 3 is 9 plus 4 is
12.
Let's see, what do we need? Right. Let me just think about what I started with. Oh, that's why. Because we're supposed to, if we're going to use the same approach, we're going to use a bigger number, 4. 4 times 3 is 12 plus 4 is 16, just like it was supposed to be. So now in this approach, we don't use steps, we use the figure number. Figure number. 3 is, we're going to change 4. Now, okay, that's a good question. Why are we adding 4? Like, I use the figure number, so that's nice and convenient. Like, if I were to turn this into a formula or something, just use the figure number times the rate of change, y plus 4. How can we explain that 4, Sarah?
No, Brad.
That 4, Tiana.
Okay, so because you went up by 3, imagine if you were going from 0 instead of figure 1. Figure 0 would be subtracted 3, and you would only have 4.
Aren't you guys?
Yeah.
Oh, that's pretty cool. So you can, I mean, if the pattern works forwards, it should work backwards. If we keep going Like, if we start here and we back up 3, we'll be at figure 2. Take 3 away from there, we'll be back at figure 1. If I take, like, this one and this one and this one away,
then you'd be
this follows
zero.
That same pattern, then we'd be at figure 0, and that would be made of 4 blocks plus 4. For the 4 blocks, it would be in figure 0. Okay? There's another way to think about it. There's lots of different ways to think about it. If we were to turn this into a field of study, these two would probably be like the most common. Like, if you asked 1,000 different people to figure out how many are in figure 21, you get a lot of this, probably, and some of this. Some people would do this. Okay. It's kind of up to each person. And then other than that, I don't think you'd see a lot of any other approach, but there'd be a few. So there's that plus 4, because we back up 1. We start figure 0. And the nice thing about it starting at figure 0 is how many steps is it to get to figure 2 if I start here? How many steps does it take to get to 2 from 0?
2.
Yeah. 1 step to get to 1, 2 steps to get to 2. How many steps to get to 21?
21.
1, 2, 3. I just count the figures from 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's how many times I would add on 3. So 21 times 3 plus those 4. Go and try this way or that way, okay? But we would need to talk about figure 0, figure 1, figure 2, figure 3, right? Good explanation. Okay. So let's see how you do completely unaided. I'll come around and help those who seem like they want a little boost. Okay. Right, so I need to ask you which figure, right? So let's call this figure 1, call this figure 2, call this figure 3. Let's say we're going to step all the way out to figure 37.
I was
going to
say 42.
But... the answer is inverse negative.
Yeah.
Just, what was 37? First, someone tell me how many blocks they calculated. How many did you get?
360.
Wait.
How?
A little bit off.
Like,
that's like 300. That's like
200.
Yeah, 300 off.
All right, so where some of you may have added 5, Carter just accidentally multiplied by 5.
It's three.
Well, I think you can spend a minute and keep running your calculation. What's the number that somebody else got?
77.
Okay, so maybe you got 77 and maybe you got 79?
Yep, I got
79. Some of you, my guess would be the most popular, second most popular answer would be 79.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's look at why it is 77. It's not 79. Huh?
I got 2 patterns.
2 patterns.
Yeah.
How so?
Yeah.
I just figured out 2 patterns for
yeah,
that.
Same.
Oh, 2 approaches.
Yeah.
Okay, there's 1 pattern, right?
Yeah, well, 2 formulas.
Yeah, okay. 2 different ways to go.
Thank you.
1 pattern we're adding on.
Yeah.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, stop messing ourselves up. Okay. How about raise your hand if you did this? Okay, raise your hand if you did this.
Oh, I didn't
read it?
Yeah.
I did something similar.
Okay.
Wait, no.
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 I didn't ask.
Yeah. Well, I'm just asking if you did this or if you did this.
Oh, I did that one.
What does this give us?
77.
What does this give us?
79.
Oh.
Okay, so, well, let's just kind of take a gamble and assume one of these is right. Which one's right?
The one on the left.
So why is this one correct and this one's not?
Because you start from 30, or you start from 2, not from
1. Start from 2?
Well, you start
from
1, but you don't count it.
You start from 1? Oh, I see what you're saying.
Yeah.
So the first step is when you go to number 2.
Yeah.
The second step would be you go to number 3.
So, like, essentially you start from 2.
Okay, so figure number 2 means the first step. Yeah, okay. So basically, you're saying this number right here that we multiply by the change is the number of times we go up, the number of steps, the number of days until day number 37, or however you want to think about it. So how many steps is it from figure number 1 to figure 37? 36, right? Always one less than the figure you want to get to. If you're starting at figure 1, right? You could start at figure 2 or figure 3, or, right? Like, let's just be silly, and let's start at figure 3. How many steps is it from figure 3 to figure 37?
34.
34, we all agree on 34?
Yeah.
Yeah, I probably could take the number of the figure minus the figure number here, and that's how many steps it's going to take to get up there. So 34 times, well, 2, that's how much it changes every time. But we're going to have to add on a different number. How much would we have to add on?
9.
5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Is this also going to 77?
Most likely not, yeah.
Most likely. That. Should give a 77 as well. Confirm or deny that?
Yeah,
yeah,
it's right,
right,
it's right.
Okay, well, people are not usually going to do that. They're going to start at figure 3. Why would they? Well, maybe they would because that was the last one they see. So this one needs to be fixed. We can fix it this way. Well, we should take 36 steps if we're going to start at figure 1. Or maybe we don't start at figure 1. What figure could we start at?
Figure 0.
How many would be in figure 0?
3.
Let's see if we can figure out what this would look like. We keep adding one on out to the right.
But if you started from 0, then it would be 6.
Yes. It's just that we would need to change this one.
Yeah.
How much do we start? So let's see. So this, like, if we weren't backwards, we would take one away, take one away, take one away from this. So we take this guy away, right? So it looks something like this. Figure 0 would. Yeah. It wouldn't have this guy here. If we go back, let's see. We just take this one off, and we back to this. So these, how many does it start with? How many are in figure 0? If I add on 2, will I get figure 1? If I put 1 there and 1 right there?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll get figure 1, which has 5. Okay. So 37 times 2, well, it does take 37 steps to get to figure 37 if we're starting from?
0.
Figure 0.
It's
so we go
plus
up.
3 then.
What's that?
Yeah.
So it'd be plus 3 because there's only 3 in this guy here, in this figure 0.
Yeah. We start from figure 36, it would be 1.
So we go 1 times 2,
plus
however many are in 36,
yeah.
Right? We don't know, but we certainly could find out. Okay. The idea here is, though, we use calculations rather than just adding on and adding on and adding on, right? We use a calculation rather than just counting up. Okay. All right. So now I'm gonna go to the next one and see how y'all do. Is it clicking with more of us than it was a minute ago?
Yes.
And for those of you who feel like no problem, then try and use figure 0 as well. Try and work starting from figure 1, do it that way, and then also work from figure 0, do it that way.
So start figure
and
here?
Yeah. Feel like you just got it. Try starting from figure 0 as well. Mm-hmm. Figure number one. To get from figure number 1 to figure number 42 is how many steps?
Oh.
Brennan?
What, do you want the answer?
Just how many steps it is to get to figure 41 from figure 1? 42. How many steps is it to go from figure 1 to figure 42?
41.
Why 41, Raymond?
Because you have to take off the, like at the beginning, you should take off 2 of the blocks at the very first one.
I don't want you to be guessing. I like, pretend I'm somebody, you know, I'm a fellow classmate. I'm not quite sure why we always have this. If it's 40, the figure 42, we go 41 steps. I don't quite understand it. Explain it to me like, I don't know.
I don't know. I just know you have to take 1 off the 42.
But you don't know why.
Well,
no laughing.
what we did with the other one is that we took two off the thing, the first squares, we took two off of them to get three.
You took two off to get three?
Like, it had the four squares and then the one on the end, and then you took off, like...
This one back here?
Yeah, that one, and then you took off the two to get figure zero.
Yes.
And then you got, it was 36 instead of 37.
Well, actually, when we backed it to figure zero, it was 37 instead of 36.
When
we backed it to figure zero, to get to figure 37 from zero, it takes 37 steps.
Oh.
Okay, let's start counting the steps, I think you'll see why. So here we start at figure zero. All right, we go to figure one. Let me see how many times I have to step up to get to figure one. One time to get up to figure one.
Okay.
To get to figure two from figure zero, one, two times. Okay. To get to figure three, one, two, three. To get to figure 37, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. 37 times I have to go up. But we're starting, at least for the moment, at figure one.
When you get to the 41 step, you can't go over it without getting to 42. Like, you can't go over it.
So if I take more than 41 steps, I go past 42.
Is
that what you're saying?
Yeah.
So I go 1 to get to 2, 2 steps gets me to 3, 3 steps gets me to 4, 41 steps gets me to 42.
Yeah.
So okay. So 36 steps. And every time we take a step, what happens to the figure?
You gain 4.
You gain 4. So, right? That's 36 groups of 4. That part is the number of squares that what?
That sort of change. That's how many squares are added
onto
the.
Added onto what?
Added onto the figure.
Which figure?
One right there.
This one?
No.
This one?
Any of
this is how much is added on?
Like, if it goes up one, then.
Okay, so 4, okay, you're explaining 4. That's how many are added onto each figure.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is 36 groups of 4 is how many is added on to which figure?
Onto the
41. What am I saying 36?
Yeah, I was like...
41.
It's onto the 41st.
That was confusing.
This is how much is added onto the 41st figure?
Yeah.
Because you multiply 41 plus 4 to get it. So then it's just 41 groups of 4, and that's all added on to each 41.
It's added on, all this is added on to this figure right here, right?
Plus three.
Not the 41st figure. This isn't added on to the 41st, but the first figure. Okay. So this is what's added on to the first figure to get the 42nd figure.
Yes.
But that's just what's added. We need to add on to the original figure, which has how many?
Three.
It has three. So we add on that three. And we get 167. Very good. Okay, now here's a weird one. If we back up to figure number 0, right, that means we're going to lose 4 if we're going this direction. Well, if I have 3 and I lose 4, where does that put me?
-1.
What's a negative 1 block? Yeah, so in numbers it makes sense. In blocks it doesn't make so much sense. So if I was going to use blocks to represent the number -1, I might put it like a dotted block. Maybe a dotted block could mean a negative block, or maybe a differently colored block, like a red block. Could you put your phone in the phone jail, please?
Yep.
Okay,
thank you.
Like a red block could be a negative block, a dotted block, circle could represent, like it just has to be something that represents something other than a positive number. So -1, that's how many blocks are back here at figure 0. Kind of weird. That's all right. How many blocks would I add on to figure, let's see, how many times would I have to go up from figure 0 to get to figure 42 times. So 42 times I'm going to add on how much?
Four.
Four blocks every time. Plus how many blocks did I start with in figure 0?
-1.
-1 blocks. Oh, so it gives us 168 minus 1, 167.
Do we have homework tonight?
We may. Let's keep going. So here's what I'm going to have happen this time. I want someone to come up with a pattern, like to arrange some blocks up here, figure 1, 2, 3, that, you know, that we can apply this to. I'm gonna have Jackson come on up.
Yeah, Jackson, I believe in
you.
Let's
see, will this work? Yeah, so you can use this, just grab right there, and it'll give you a block. Alright, so you're doing figure 1? Okay, figure 1. Now for figure 2, right? So you might want to draw that figure 1. Take it away, maybe? Is that what you want?
No, right.
Oh, we'll do it after we get all three figures. I think we're all on board with it. Put one up there. So let's just try the ad real quick. Yeah. And then we grab all those and hit this little button right here. Just tap it. There you go. Copy. There you go.
So good.
A lot of work.
Okay. Very good. Okay, so now we'll get you a pen and you could write figure 1, 2, 3 if you want.
Nope.
Is this the right kind of pattern?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. What kind of pattern would you call it?
Goes up by 2.
Yeah.
A rate of change.
Okay, so it goes up by 2, like adds 2, right? Let me just throw some other patterns out there. It could double every time. It could triple every time. It could be cut in half every time. We could add the next odd number, right? But it adds the same amount every time. So you tell us, Jackson, what figure are we going to?
Do something big.
Oh, something big.
80.
1,000.
They're begging for a big
1,000.
Yeah, 2,000.
No.
1,000.
No. Do like 500.
I'm sure they're scared of 1,000.
Yeah, it's pretty simple. 1,006.
1,084.
Yeah.
Okay, we're doing this.
Thank you very much.
Really?
Oh my god.
1,084. Hey, I heard that.
All right, figure 1,084. All right, so what should we get?
2,172.
Oh, 2,170.
2,170.
2,172. Well, let's find out. How many times do we go up? If we go from figure 1 to figure 1,084, how many times do we have to go?
1,083
times. 1,083, not 1,084. Okay, times
two.
Because
it goes up by 2.
It goes up by 2 every time. So that's how many 2s we're gonna have. Plus 4. Why plus 4?
Because you didn't start with 4. You started with 0.
So because we did, we should start with 4.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, we should start with 4. So let's add on the 4. Okay. Or we could do 1,084 times 2 plus what? 2y2?
Because
0
is 2.
Because, yeah, figure 0 has 2 in it. Okay? All right, for your homework, from this guy right here, figure out that challenge. If I go to figure x, what's the formula for getting to figure x? All right, have a good day.